Nassella tussock is a problem for farmers in the east coast of New Zealand because it is highly invasive and not palatable to stock. Well, Nassella tussock or Nassella trichotoma has been present in New Zealand for over 100 years, but it wasn't identified as a problem until probably the late 1930s, and by this time it had spread to large parts of the east coast of New Zealand.
Give it a chance, particularly on dry faces where many of our other better grasses won't cope. The drought tolerance of this plant enables it to establish and thrive.
Over the last 7 or 8 decades, it has cost New Zealand farmers a lot of money to bring about control, to get the numbers down to manageable levels and to prevent the impact of Nassella on arable farming.
We've been there before, we'd never want to go back really. It's such an essential part of maintaining dry North Canterbury hill country. If you've got Nassella, it's something that has to be done every year.
As farmers, we farm for two reasons. Obviously, on an annual basis for cash flow and profit, but we also farm an asset. And if we allow the Nassella to become too much of a pest, that can reduce the value of that asset for us in the long term.
Nassella tussock occupies over 400,000 hectares in Canterbury across 1,450 properties. There is a large proportion of Canterbury where Nassella tussock is not known, but a lot of that hasn't been searched or checked before. And many of the landowners in those areas actually don't know how to identify it. And this behind us is an example of exactly that. Nassella tussock that has been here for probably a few decades. And it's only recently been reported when the landowner actually spoke to some Environment Canterbury officers who were able to come and have a look and actually identify it for him.
They can be easily confused with some of our native tussocks. What can happen actually is that they can grow as part of a silver tussock or a fescue tussock. So it looks like one tussock. And if you approach it in one direction, it looks like a silver tussock. And as you've gone past, if you look back, actually it's a Nassella tussock. So it's easy for them to hide. And we do find that in grubbing operations in Canterbury, it's the big plants that get missed. The Nassella tussock plant is a perennial and it produces flowers every year. So in its early stages of flowering, the florets are very purple. As the seeds mature after pollination, those purple flowers turn to a straw colour. These seeds typically, they don't fall out. The panicle detaches from the tussock, and if the weather conditions are right, particularly if you've got a thermal, these panicles will just go up on the thermals and blow away. And it can go very long distances. A single panicle can contain around 70 seeds. Now this plant is approximately 120 millimetres in basal diameter, and the square of 120 is about 14,000. So this plant, at this size, will produce 14,000 seeds roughly per plant per year.
Nassella tussock is spread not only by wind, but also by water, stock, machinery, people and crops. So it's very important that the control of Nassella tussock is done in a very systematic way annually to try and prevent as much seeding as possible.
We can visually identify the plants more effectively in the late autumn and the early winter, and we can also still get around because it's not too wet or muddy, and we can also not impact on lambing or calving or any of these type of operations later in the, you know, into the spring.
When you're out on the country, you're always sort of looking for it really. So you know, and you quite often it's really helpful to work with grubbers. So again, you recognise the work they do and how to pick it, because there are often the areas that do get missed. You've got to try and stop any sort of major seeding.
By undertaking our work early, if there's any areas that we discover that we've missed or we haven't done as effectively as we would like, it gives us time to actually remedy that before we get into the seeding season. So we're able to actually rectify any issues before it becomes a problem.
If you find Nassella tussock on your property, the best thing you can do is report it to Environment Canterbury, and we'll help you understand the best ways to go about control, the best time to control it, and you'll be able to assess whether you can do that control work yourself or hire a contractor. Control methods include grubbing, but there are also herbicide applications for dense areas, which are probably less common these days.
There are no herbicides that will take this grass out and leave the other grasses and palatable legumes in the sward.
We need to not only keep control of our pests for ourselves, but also to protect our neighbours on our boundaries and make sure that we're playing our part in protecting their properties as well.
If you've got Nassella, it has to be controlled every year. So the sooner you get onto it, the easier it is.
Keep a lookout for plants with seed heads like this in the summer, and particularly this purple coloration, which will be particularly evident on the plant in the main part of the flowering season, which is in November, December.
We're depending upon the people in areas where it's not known to actually be vigilant and report it where they can. And we'll work with those people and make sure that they are fully informed and help them to get on top of the problem if it arises.